Hello, I'm welcome to the NorCal like iRacing series coming to you from Juliet, Illinois for the running of Chicagoland 75 here at Chicagoland Speedway. As the field begins to roll off here, we'll take a look at our starting grid. And runner one with the 8 of Josh Allen will take the pole position. Two is outside, a hometown boy, and the number one is Jarrett Darling. And runner two got a Big Sexy in the third position. Two is outside with the Taylor Swift machine of Sean Williams. And row number three with the 28, the old man, Cody Miller. Two is outside and number 90 at Cole Baloney. Row four, we got the 29, Hunter Combs. Two is outside, Mr. Yeehaw. Elvis fans, Terrell Baker. Row number five, we got number 97, James Colabali. Two is outside, number 24, our Tyler Hugo Victory. Row number six, we got the 41, Thomas Mercier in the 11th position. And in 12, number five, Spencer Owens. Row number 7, we got the 31 of Cannon Henry in the 13th position. Two is outside, the number 70 of Aaron Smith. And that will run out your running order. So this will be a 50 lap race around this racetrack. Should expect a lot of 3, maybe and possibly 4 wide action as we head into the corners. This track's plenty wide enough to see that kind of racing. You're going to expect a lot of blocking to that end time. Guys, we're protecting that bomb lane. Make sure no one gets the inside of them. Anyway, coming off of turn four, pace car makes a hard left-hand turn down the pit road here, and Josh Rahm will lean him towards the green flag. And the green flag's now underway here in the Chicago 75. And we already see, we're already 3 wide, even possibly 4 wide already, as we head into turn one. That 74 got a great start to him in the first corner. And it's getting really tight there. Josh Rahm is stuck there right in the middle. And it looks like the 74 will take the race lead. Had an amazing start. Time it perfectly as it head into the fair corner. Here comes Cody Miller to the inside. Now look at this pack of cars as they make their way from 3 and 4. Coming out turn 4 to complete the first lap. And we're 3 wide back there. I think that's a battle for possibly the 8th or 9th positions. We're 3 wide again here. Sean Williams all the way to the top line. Here comes Terrell Baker trying to force his way up through the middle. Still side by side for second place. I think one car might have caught the wall there coming out turn two. And look at this. Here comes Cody Miller. Look at the inside. Here comes Sean Williams. They're 3 wide for the race lead as I head into 3 and 4. Sean Williams all the way down the bottom trying to take the race lead away from the 74. They're going to be side by side coming to the start finish line. Now they're triple foul back and for the second position. Really close between Sean Williams and that's the 28 of Cody Miller. As they make their way out of turn two, still 3 wide. These guys cannot get away from each other. Here comes Jarrett Darling. He's right there for the mix. Sean Williams taking her a look down low. And it looks like there's some separation. A couple cars are laying in the back. I think there's going to be a huge wreck in the way these guys are racing each other. It wouldn't surprise him one bit. As they make their way back in turn one, Sean Williams still on the bomb, still looking for that race lead. As the field makes their way off of turn number two, see the 74 is still there, and they're 3 wide back here for 4th place to see Jarrett Darling stuck in the middle. Sean Williams getting a big run to the inside, trying to look for the race lead. As we come to complete another lap, here comes Cody Miller up top, trying to make it 3 wide as we pass the start finish line.
He's going to get that big drive going into turn number one, but he won't be able to hold it up there. Got that bottom line, you know, get a good stay down there, try to get a good exit, but he's keeping it going up there.
And someone really dropping out of line there in the back. You see Cody Miller takes the lead here.
Yeah, Cody Miller hit that big run off the top lane. He'll take over the top spot. Now the 74 really, really falling back. Got a horrible 3 and 4. And he's going to go back from the lead all the way back to 5th place.
Comes Jared, trying to look for second here under Sean. Backs out.
Yeah, so you get a big run these cars. You just get behind people, you get bad entry in the corner, just get really tight. And right now, Cody Miller, we've seen in these Cadillac races where he gets up front, he becomes really hard to pass. And I expect the same here. He's really good at these mile and a half tracks on the Cadillac cars.
Nickname is the Caddy Goat.
Yeah. 74 trying to crawl his way back up here as he gets to the end. It's outside of Sean Williams. Sean dives it down really far down. Gets to the inside of Jarrett Darling. We're 3 wide again.
Wasn't able to hold it down there in the bottom. Would Jarrett Darling get a good run on the leader? Try to see if he can make a move going in. He's trying to go high, but I don't think he's going to be able to go anywhere there because that bottom lane's a little bit good, but he washed up. He's not going to be able to complete the pass, though.
Don, Jerry, you got a pretty good exit off of turn four. I don't think he'll be able to clear Cody Miller as they head into turn one as these guys back here starting to recover. Here comes Josh from a big head of steam here as he's blinking in and out constantly. Looks like he's going to try to, he's going to force to make it three wide here. He's still trying to force it three wide, and he does. He's coming up for the middle.
And try to make a three wide turn to stay on the bottom down there. See, the leader got a good run.
Shaw
got into the wall.
Yeah, Shaw Williams has got the wall big time. Come off of turn four. That's really going to hurt that car. He might have some suspension damage, and that car's going to be falling back here.
Dropping like a rock.
We're now side by side with the 29 Hunter Combs.
The leader, you got Jared trying to pass the 28 car. Going on the high side, he still can't get it done, but he's trying. He's trying his hardest. 28's trying to get can't really stay on the bottom too well, but it's good enough as Josh tries to make it three wide.
Three wide.
And Josh
he's about
is
to lose
go down.
The bottom.
Good run by Jared. Jared comes down.
Oh, we got contact.
Oh, boy.
74.
Watch out, boys.
Oh, he's coming back up on the racetrack. This ain't going to be good.
Be bad.
Oh, God.
Jeez.
And that destroyed the front end of whoever that is. That car is demolished. 74 is somehow still rolling. What the thing
is
the replay?
He can still
here.
Drive away. It's a miracle.
See here, yeah, it looks like Revan just came low right there on, I believe that's Hunter Combs. Yes, Hunter Combs.
Off in La La Land, not paying attention to his spotter. There's a car down there.
Oh my God.
Hunter rolled.
Yeah, that there's no safer barrier down there.
No safer barrier.
Good
thing these cars are.
I believe that's, I don't know who that is. I think that's.
Can't remember who that is, yeah.
Tom Mercier? No, maybe Tyler.
I think that's Tyler there just. Completely bulldozed through to 74, and 74 comes down on Hunter. And this rolls
a big
over.
Hit on this Jeez. Side. Where's the energy gonna
here.
Go? We're just gonna flip.
Yep, so, hello.
Oh,
look at that.
Just came back from the moon.
He's on board with the 74. Like, he's trying to shoot the gap there. Then realize that 29 is inside. This is gonna be a hit.
Oh boy. Grab the parachutes.
Amazing that car is still able to run after that contact, and here's the car that bulldozes through him here.
Because brakes are boring.
Yeah.
Ooh. You hear he got out, but it's just, he wasn't expecting them to really be up that high.
Yep. So we'll be doubled up for the restart here. Jared Darring with the lead. Josh Allman in second. Cody Miller in third, and we got Spencer Owens in fourth. Pace car off down pit road. Green flags back out. Run away here.
Good start by Jared.
Got
25.
Way
out.
Yeah,
Josh didn't really get too good on the high side.
You're going to have to see that 28 Cody Miller. He's going to get a hell of a drive coming off of turn two here. He's going to try to take a look to the outside here of Jared Darling. Here he comes. Josh Rahm here trying to go all the way top, trying to make it three wide up here. I just don't think he'll be able to make that work.
It's just so hard to get around somebody on the high side.
Well, here comes Spencer.
Ooh, here comes Spencer.
Mr. Owens here going to the inside here. Here comes Josh Rahm trying to shoot the gap, trying to make it three wider as he passes the Red Bull machine.
Man, that
got
tight.
A little close there.
You're starting
gonna to get three wide.
Separation here. You got this pack up here, about five cars, and it kind of spreads out to the second pack. So these guys are leaning right on top of each other here.
Can't turn. Might as well use the car above or below you.
Yeah, eight wheels are better than four.
I gotta tell you.
Here comes Josh Brown trying to get that running. He's trying to look to the outside of Spencer Owens here. He says outside. Jared Darling right behind him.
Jared Darling could give him a little bump. But no, no. A little bit high there.
Oh,
no!
Four wide.
Good God almighty. Here we go, down to one.
He's going left. None of them do.
Oh, here comes Spence, but here comes Selby.
Cody, no. They're about to run on the top line. Making it four wide. He's going to take the race lead.
Good God almighty.
What a move by the 28 of Cody Miller. And we're three wide back here again. This is some incredible racing here in Chicago with these cars.
This is so fun. So fun to watch.
We got the, I believe that's the 31 of Kane Henry there. He's caught this group here. But, oh man,
Spencer's
look at
trying to pull away. Go down low.
Oh, he's on the apron.
Oh, he's not going
to
let it back up.
Jared's on the apron. He has to let off. To check up a little bit there. It's going to mess up Josh. Going to go three wide.
I tell one thing about Jared right now. I'm not too happy right now with Spencer Owens. Like, he ran him all the way down on an apron. I did not let him back up onto the racetrack. So Jared might be a little mad right now with that five car.
Bottom line, though, it's so valuable, you know, if there's any chance you can get not to, you know, let the car back up, you know, to just take it, you know. Don't mind any of the repercussions of doing so, but... And Jared's trying to get a good run on Spencer on the high side, coming off a four.
See?
Yeah, let's take a look for the pack here. We got 25 Terrell Baker, we got some more of these guys. We got the 74 and the 29 who were involved in that last accident. So we go back up here. These guys, they're racing.
Spencer didn't really get that good of an entry there.
Tell me, Cody Miller is actually starting to pull away also slightly from these guys. These guys are racing each other really hard.
6 seconds.
Yeah, I think he's going to reel him back in right here. He's going to have that run, get that draft. The draft is so effective. These cars get such a pull off the car in front of you. Look at that right there. Jared's already to the outside of Cody Miller.
But then it's like once you get out there, it's like you just hit a wall air. You just cannot go anywhere.
Yeah,
that's why
these,
it's so hard to complete passes on the high side.
Yeah, these cars, like, you get a big run, but once you kind of pull out and you hit that brick of wall of air, the car just loses its momentum so quickly. You can't really slingshot draft these things. You get alongside, but you can't do. Oh man, look at that! He's on the grass.
Agricultural racing.
Got the preferred line though down there.
Yep.
Lawnmower. Can make the pass.
Pass in the grass, hill style.
Yeah, he made it work. Jarrett Durring to the race lead.
What a pass! That's 28's looking low. I don't think he's gonna get. Oh, he made it. He's in there. Got back down to the bottom. And makes the leap back, or takes the leap back.
Oh, we got contact.
Oh, that's
go.
Oh, that's a death. Boy. Watch out.
Josh Rowan, Spencer Rowan, he's coming back across racetrack, boys. Look out.
Oh.
Because again, brake pedals are boring, and nobody else hit him. It's always good.
Oh, somebody back there stopped.
Donuts hearing this car turn back around. Nerd caution is out. Take a look at the replay as I'm fooling around the camera. Here we go. Oh. It looks like Josh Rowan just pushed really badly and just turned him.
This got Spence way tight. He got hooked.
I can forward really
when that happens.
Yeah, we got one car back here that's going completely through the grass. That's Hunter Combs.
Well, if you don't feel like stopping, just go through the grass.
Yeah, you can see Josh Rowan, he just gets really tight. He goes up into Spencer. Spencer comes back down and comes back down and he clips Josh, and Josh makes some pretty heavy contact with the outside wall.
Yeah,
that's
what happens
with these cars. If you don't get the right entry, it washes up and you could let off, you could get the brakes all you want, it ain't gonna really help, and that's what happens. Sometimes you get into others and crash.
Okay. We're going to be double up for restart.
Stoppage.
Here. Cody Miller, still your race leader. Pace car will pull off on the pit road here. Green flags back down. We're back underway here at Chicagoland with the Cadillac Series. Got that Red Bull machine still on the outside. I still don't know who that is. Let's take a look at the scoring here. That's Cole Baloney.
Oh, yep. Baloney there.
Yeah. You know, I don't think any bologna mixed with Red Bull thing that would not taste all that well. But you see, these guys are free wide again. See, Kelly Miller just protecting on them.
That's all you can pretty much do.
Got really tired there.
Jared looking to make it three wide for second there. He does.
Yep. Jared going to the outside. Here comes Sean Williams trying to look back to the outside. Oh, look out. There's contact behind him. Can he hang on to it? And look out.
Oh, my God.
Good God almighty. Call 911.
And the Red Bull machine has been crushed.
Along with some crushed Legos.
And he stepped on some Legos. Let's take a look at replay. That was a vicious crash here. And it looks like he just kind of missed.
Oh yeah, he
corner.
Just went straight right up into Jared. See, 25 gets into him there.
That was a good save by Jared there, though.
Wow, I mean, 74 got really lucky.
Caden Henry didn't know what was going on.
Think he was
up and flipping.
Yeah. Someone, that's on some sturdy Legos right there. Both the 31 and the 90 have been completely destroyed. That was a pretty horrific, right? We had two really awful wrecks so far in this race. Yeah, this 90 does not turn for the corner. The car just never hooks. Jared Drone is a hell of a save.
He probably has a little bit of damage, though, but it doesn't really matter at this point.
Right into the fence goes the 9 of Cole Pelani. And see, can't Henry
a sandwich flip so much in my life.
Yeah, both of them are on the roof.
A deli meat.
This is on board with him. Yeah, the thing doesn't
turn. Oh, yeah,
turn.
He turned way too late.
Oh,
jeez.
Thank God for the Hans device, I tell you, or else that'd be one smushed piece of baloney.
He's on board with Kane here. They say he thinks they're gonna stay down, but that car comes back up. Sparks are flying from underneath the car. Oh man!
Oh!
And after we've killed a couple more drivers off, or double up for restart, Cody Miller still here later. Now we got Shaw Williams to his outside. Pace car pulls off, green flags back out, we're underway here. So we got less than 20 laps to go. Seeing Cody Miller when he gets that lay, it's just so hard to take that lay away from him. Here comes Sean Williams, he's on the run. He can't look down the bottom, Cody Miller's protecting it, so he has to go to the top lane. He's gonna bring everybody with him. But you see Jared Darling, he's going to go down low. Oh man, he's getting really tight right there, all over the back bumper in that 28. There's James Caballi there in that 97, he's in that Pennzoil machine. Seems like these guys get a little bit spread out here in the start, but as the run goes on, they start to slowly close back on top of each other.
Sean trying to side drive.
Yeah, he's got pinched down. Cody Miller, he's got pinched down. That way, it has Cody, he has to lift. Because
if you're
him
pinching these, you can't really, you can't really still get a run off the high side. It's just these cars are just so good on the bottom lane.
Here comes Jared Darling now. He's going to take
over. Someone's
second.
In the wall.
Yeah, someone back there is in the wall. Couldn't tell who that was. Here comes this 74 to the inside of Sean Williams. He was about 15, 20 feet in the air towards the start of the race, and here he is battling for third.
Sean washed up coming off a four there. As Jared's trying to make a run on the high side for the lead.
Before I'm starting to get a little closer, here comes Josh on back. And look at this run. Jared Darling's getting a pretty good run off of turn two on top. But just cannot get far enough ahead or actually wasn't able to get ahead at all there. Now, he can get a little bit of a run coming off the corners, but it's just not enough to really complete the pass on Cody Miller. What he really needs to do, he needs to kind of get right behind him and force him off the bottom lane. But he's got
that's
this
all you can hope for is a mistake.
Give him the old chrome horn in the middle of the corner.
Yeah, plastic.
Yeah. Or fiberglass, where his car's made out. But here it comes. Yep, here it comes in 98. And here, all right, 89 and the 74. That's going to make life hard, Jared Darling. He's going to get back to the inside. There he's looking down below.
Josh is trying to make a three wide, but he can't.
Oh, here comes
Jared.
Yep.
Jared, good pass on the bottom.
Yeah, we're telling him.
He can make
like,
it stick.
He's got to force his 28 off the bomb line. And he's there. Oh, here comes the 74 looking to the inside, making it
three
wide for race lead.
Just three wide.
Oh. Man,
good run by the 28 in the center.
He
get
got
that big drive off
hooked up.
Four.
Yeah, I tell you, he's got that car hooked up. I mean, it's like whatever line that 28 is in, he just manages to get to the lead and pull away.
Yeah, we're starting to get more and more cars up here. Now, can the 74, can he do anything with him? When he kind of got to the inside, or Jared, that really kind of screwed Jared's run up. There he goes to the outside.
That panic swerve out to the outside lane there. Josh is going to get under him, though.
Yeah, Josh, I'm going to try and make it. Try to look for second place here. Oh, there comes Jared Darling. He's looking inside. They're trying to make it four wide.
Almost four wide.
It's four wide. Good run there in the entry by Josh.
Yeah, Sean had to back out of it. Oh, man, look at that.
Really get that guy back. What a block.
Still block.
And we're back to single foul for the first four positions.
I'd be too happy about that.
I figure, yeah, right now this is Jerry's best opportunity. He's got to get to the inside as we got 10 laps to go, but he's going to go to the outside. I just don't think the outside's going to work.
He can get a run off the corner, but he just doesn't have enough.
You just don't get enough of a run off the top line to kind of just to complete the pass. You can stay even with the guy, but you can't complete the pass up there. See, he's just getting this really tight up there, causes him to really drift out, and just when he drifts out like that, he's just gonna run so much extra time up there that he loses any sort of speed advantage he gets from running up there. See, we're double foul for the first four positions.
And Jared had a good run there through the center of the corner. Let's see. Not clear.
He's just entering the corner way too high. He's got to go in a little bit more shallow. He's just losing too much time going in that high.
You got to stay high though. You have to, because hopefully you can get enough of a run on the straightaway here.
Side by side. This is going to come down to who gets to run, come off turn four the best. So far, it seems like the bomb comes off turn four better than the top. Here comes the 74. He's starting to get a little bit closer. Sean Williams right behind him. They're side by side.
He washed up a little bit there.
I feel like if Jared just gets just a little bit lower, like how you said, right?
Take it three
the
wide.
Corner.
Yep, 74 on the very top. Not going to be able to make it work. Here comes Sean Williams looking to the inside again. Yeah, it seems like Jared, he's starting to get a little bit better runs off the top.
But the 74 could help push him, he can get enough of a run in either the back or front stretch, especially the front, because he gets one hell of a run most of the time off of turn four.
Six laps to go. This is the last lap for a caution. Jared is trying his best, trying to make that outside work. I tell you one thing, if I was Sean Williams right now, he were to get to run, I would dive it down low, make it three wide. Oh, here comes the 74. I figured there was some contact between those two. And here it comes, this is five laps to go. So if a Akash comes out, they race back to the start finish line, and that will be the finish of the race. Five car shootout up here. Here comes James Colabolli trying to get back up into this mix. Hunter Combs. He was involved in that first caution. He's up there in sixth place.
Just no matter what, towards the end of these races, no matter what happens at the beginning, he could still be in it.
He's getting a little bit closer.
He's trying to look low, but he couldn't quite make it there.
Jared Irvine's trying to get a little bit of a run off the top lane every single lap. Down the back straightaway they go. Four laps to go. Here comes Hunter Combs looking to the inside of Caldwell. Six car, all underneath the blanket. Here comes a seventh place car up to Ryle Baker. Three laps to go. Looks like a 180 mile per hour pace lap here.
He's got nowhere to go.
28 came off the bottom a little bit.
It looks like the 28 was just starting to push a little bit there. This is going to be really close. I think the advantage is starting to swing over a little bit to the one car. 74 is right there. 74 is going to look all the way down.
Put that block on him. Almost in the grass.
He's looking. They're bouncing off each other. Oh, there's contact there.
That's Hunter Combs.
Come back across the racetrack. Oh, no. Is that going to bring him? Yeah, it does. This is the last lap. Wow, massive block by Terrell Baker. Looks like the one he's ahead. Can he hang on to it? Going for three and four for the final time.
He's in the wall.
Here it comes. Cody Miller. He's going to win the race. Three wide for second place.
Oh, what a bump.
I think the Sony 4 got it there right at the end.
And here comes the field.
There's death everywhere.
Caskets everywhere.
Wait. Oh, whoever that is. Screw that all up.
Miss everybody.
Burnouts aren't a thing in this league whenever you win.
Graveyard there.
So we need to see what brought out that final caution in this race. Actually, I see the race to the start finish line here. Jared Darling looks like just got in front of us a tad bit too soon and got tight. And he's going
just trying to get everything, but
hit the wall right here. And that just kills his momentum.
Good for the 78 or 74. 74 can get a
74 and
solid second. Almost, Sean almost passed him too, but.
Yeah, that was really close there for third. Let's take a look at our final finishing results. Cody Miller, victory. John Berry, second. Jared Darling, third. Fourth, Sean Owens, and fifth, Hunter Combs.
Sixth place, Spencer Owens. Seventh place, Tom Mercier. Eighth place, Aaron Smith. Ninth place, Josh Robin. And rounding out the top 10, Tyler Vickery.
Then in 11th, we got Terrell Baker, who's always back there. We got James Caldwell in 12th. We got Caden always running 13th. And then we got Cole Baloney after that big crash earlier in the race, finishing 14th.
And that is your finishing results. And here's your points. Sean Owens with a 2-point advantage over Jared Irvine. John Berry is only 6 points behind. Hunter Combs is only 7 points behind. Those four are really close right now on points. So, guys, final thoughts on the race?
The guy who keeps winning the race isn't even in the running for the championship.
Well, you know, if he would start more than four races, you know.
Well. Oh, well.
Just saying. All right, well. I'd like to thank y'all for watching this NORC broadcast, and we'll see y'all next time for the next Cadillac race, which will be at Las Vegas. Thank y'all for watching, and have a safe and good night.